This week on BGTV,
Matthew Galgano will be shedding light on a very special club here at the high school.
Adam Kelman will be highlighting the boys' tennis team.
We will take a trip to experience opening day at everyone's favorite summer spot with Jonathan Wallen.
Lucas Kaufman will spotlight the middle school production of High School Musical.
Lastly, we'll find out what mysteries Miranda will try to solve this week on her latest installment of Mysteries with Miranda.
Hey Wizards!
I'm Reagan Murphy.
And I'm Megan Miskovic.
And this is BGTV. BG Designs is a club that showcases Wizards' artistic talents as they design different logos, stickers, and merchandise for different clubs at the high school and organizations around the town. This week, Matt will be giving us a closer look at this newly developed club and its amazing, talented students.
Hey Wizards, this is Matt Galgano from BGTV, and today I'm going to be showcasing one of Washingtonville's talented digital arts club. Let's check it out.
Essentially, the purpose of BG Designs is to provide a way for students to be involved in graphic design in the school, but also have a way that other clubs can get some t-shirts made or water bottles or any other things that they're really looking to have merch for their club. My goal is just to provide students with access to graphic design. Obviously, we have classes that offer some stuff in graphic design, but the club is just a way for them to get like real world experience in almost a like fake design firm within the school. So we actually like have our students leading all of the design projects, and they're the ones giving each other feedback so they can get that real world experience to see what it would be like.
My leadership position is creative director, and I oversee each creative team. We have three different creative teams in BG Designs. We have the production team, which uses our equipment to produce what we create, and we have the design team, which creates all the designs, and we have the marketing team, which handles the website.
My leadership position at BG Designs is executive financial officer. I'm the head of the production team. Basically, I oversee all of the production team. I take care of the money side of things and basically our output for the actual club.
And my leadership position is the senior production tech. And what I do is I oversee all the in-house merch that we make in the production team.
I'm a senior designer, so basically I designed logos and stickers so far for clubs and fundraisers, like the vinyl stickers and the stickers for the class of 2024. Being in BG Designs has taught me that in the real world, you're gonna really rely on other people.
My leadership position is senior marketing manager for the BG Designs Club, and basically what I do is kind of oversee the production of our club website, and I kind of assign jobs to the different members of my team, and we all kind of collaborate on creating one large website and other marketing strategies to kind of get the message out about our club.
Really, I think the best thing students can gain is getting that real world experience in graphic design. It's a great opportunity for them to be able to see if they actually like graphic design, see if they would want to pursue it in college or just after high school. And they have such an awesome opportunity to like build their portfolio, because we have so many projects coming in from other clubs requesting different types of merch. So they have the opportunity to design so many different projects and then also produce them if they're a part of our production team.
Well, seems like we have some pretty talented Wizards. This is Matt Galgano signing off.
On Tuesday, April 5th, the boys' tennis team had their first home match of the season. This week, Adam will highlight this match and will be getting some impromptu interviews with the players.
What's up, Wizards? No need to fear, Adam Kelman is here with your sports update for the week.
On March 29th, the varsity boys baseball team had their season opening game against Newburgh and unfortunately were defeated 28-11. With this loss, Charlie Gorgulio went 3-for-4 at bat with 4 RBIs and a home run.
The boys then traveled to Monroe Woodbury for a game on April 1st, where they were sadly defeated 14-3. Dean Cox hit a home run, pitched 2 innings allowing 0 earned runs, and struck out 3 batters. Also on April 1st, the varsity lacrosse team had their first game of the season where they were matched up with FDR and won 13-4. Sean Creedon scored 6 goals to help will the team to a victory. The track and field team had their first meet at Minisink on March 29th where they took the dub. With the team down at 1 point in the meet, the girls discus team of Emily Snyder, Jade Sampson, and Ziona Wright took 1st, 2nd, and 3rd to help push the team for a victory. Awesome job, Wizards. And now, I think it's time I took a little trip to the boys varsity tennis team to check on some of the guys about their matches.
Yo. Yo, what's up, man? So, Lucas, tell me, bro. Coffee was spilled, but we're good. How are you feeling after that match? What went into it, and how are you feeling overall?
I feel good. I've been preparing, you know, and it's just it was a fun time out there.
So now, what exactly was the score, and how many sets did it take for you to win?
I won 2 sets. I won 6-0, 6-0. Yeah, it was fun. I liked it.
So domination, basically.
Yeah, domination.
Domination. That's what I like to hear.
Yeah.
You heard it here. Alright. We got Owen here catching the big dubs here. So Owen, how you feeling? How did you feel in the middle of that match? When you were unsure whether you'd be able to take the set or not, how'd you feel?
Well, you know, I wasn't really so unsure if I was going to not be able to take the set or not. I could tell I was kind of getting in my head a little, just not feeling proper. He changed the strategy a little bit, but I just had to adapt. So,
were you able to like control yourself, and is that what a big part of how you were able to be successful there?
Well, I think really just adaptation is the biggest part. Like, he ended up adapting himself to hit lobs a lot, so I just kept the ball short and then waited for my chance to volley.
Alright. You heard it.
Well, unfortunately, that's going to wrap up this week's sports with Adam Kelman. I'll catch you guys next week. And remember, stay classy, Washingtonville.
Now it's time for the weekly announcements.
Attention all students who may be interested in wrestling. Washingtonville Wrestling will be hosting wrestling intramurals for grades 6 to 12 on Tuesdays and Thursdays after school. It will be from 2:30 p.m. to 4 p.m. beginning April 5th. See Coach Lee or stop by the athletic office for more information.
On Thursday, April 21st, SUNY Orange will be hosting an instant admission event for Washingtonville High School at 11:15 a.m. There is no application fee. Please visit the guidance office to pick up an application and to register for the event.
The Little Britain Art Expo is Friday, April 22nd from 6:30 p.m. to 8:30 p.m. Our Honor Society is looking for volunteers for art stations. Volunteer hours are from 6 to 9 p.m. Please see the sign-up genius on Google Classroom or email Ms. Held. This is a great way to earn community service hours that are required for the June induction.
Permission slips to the Art Honor Society field trip to the SUNY New Paltz Art Galleries on Friday, April 29th can be found on the Google Classroom or in Ms. Held's room 121. This field trip is free to all NAHS members. Signed permission slips are due to Ms. Held by Friday, April 22nd.
Are you interested in traveling to Ireland, Scotland, and England next year? If so, see Ms. Van in room 232 or Ms. Miller in room 206 for details.
Up next, we'll be highlighting a local business, but first, stay tuned for a short commercial break.
Have you ever dreamed to grow up and be an amazing dancer? Well, here at New York Performing Arts Center, we make your dreams come true. Dancers, always remember to dream, believe, imagine, and achieve.
Weir's Ice Cream is a local business that is extremely popular in the community. With over 30 flavors of homemade ice cream and a soft serve that is to die for, this business will easily satisfy your ice cream cravings. On Friday, April 1st, Weir's opened for the season, and luckily, Jonathan was there to capture the moment.
Hey Wizards, my name is Jonathan Wand, and today we're going to be taking a look at a staple business in the Washingtonville community, Weir's Ice Cream.
This weekend, Weir's Ice Cream opened its doors for business for the first time since September of last year, and as expected, Wizards flocked to get a bite. I had the opportunity to speak with Michael Weir, son of Weir's co-founder Arthur Weir, about what makes Weir's special.
My family's been running this place since 1956, when my father started it with his father. I've been helping out for, well, since I was a teenager really, but I've definitely been more involved in the last several years. We're very honored by the way that people look at us, by the treasured memories that they carry through their childhood about this place. And we always want to do our best to live up to it and really give people the same experience that they've loved all of their lives in some cases.
Next, I spoke with Jackson Vitterup, a longtime employee of Weir's, about his time working for the business.
So I've worked here since the summer after eighth grade, so I guess we're on 4 years now. And I really like that it's like a summer job, so it works really well with school and everything. I definitely think it's a staple in the community. It's been here for forever. And I came here my whole life and everything. And I know a lot of people come here all the time too.
And lastly, what's your favorite ice cream?
My favorite flavor is probably chocolate chip on a cone with chocolate sprinkles.
You know, it's really tough to pick a favorite flavor. I love so many things down here. I'm a hard ice cream guy myself, and I gotta say that blueberry crumble is definitely my favorite flavor.
Personally, I'm a Cookie Monster guy, so I had to get a cone on the way out.
Can I get a Cookie Monster and a regular waffle cone? Thank you, Weir's, for having me, and I'll see you next time.
Last Friday and Saturday, the middle school put on their annual spring musical. This year, they tackled the Disney original movie, High School Musical. Lucas will take us behind the scenes to see how this play came to life.
Hey Wizards, it's Lucas here, and this week I'm bringing you to the middle school to take you backstage of their spring production, High School Musical. I'm here with Troy and Gabriella of the High School Musical production. So, can you tell me what your favorite scene in the show is?
Stick to the status quo.
Yeah, I'd have to agree.
Other than Sharpay, who's your favorite character in the show?
I really love Coach Bolton. I think it's just fun. It's just funny he gets to scream all the time.
And remember, the chain is only as strong as its weakest link. When the goal gets tough, the top gets tough! All
okay, Wizards, I'm here with Gianna, who plays Kelsey. What's your favorite scene in the show?
Me, Gabriella, and Troy are all in the theater, and they just had a big argument, and they said they weren't going to do the callbacks anymore, but Troy comes in singing down the audience, and they make up, and then we do the callbacks.
In your eyes, I feel in my heart.
What an amazing show. Great job, middle schoolers.
Finally, the moment you've all been waiting for. Here is Miranda with her next installment of Mysteries with Miranda.
Hey,
this word?
Pecan.
Not pecan?
No.
Why?
Definitely not. It's no. Terrible. No.
Okay.
No.
Okay. How do you guys say it?
Pecan.
Pecan. Not pecan?
Ew.
No.
Why?
No. This is wrong.
This is wrong.
Yeah.
This is wrong.
Thank you. Thank you. Do you guys want to IBS? How do you say this word?
Data.
Data, not data?
It's data.
It's data.
Okay, how do you say this word?
Pecan.
Not pecan?
No. Pecan.
Why?
It's pecan.
Pecan. It's pecan, bro. What's wrong with you? It's pecan.
What? It's pecan, bro.
Pecan.
It's pecan.
How do you say this word?
Pecan. I'm not saying it in front.
No, it's just.
Okay. Oh, that word.
Yeah, how do you say it?
Oh, how would I say it? Oh, thank you. I would say gif.
No.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. It's my opinion, right? Potato, potato, tomato, tomato.
Thank you. How do you say this word?
That's pecan.
That's pecan.
Bro, that's pecan.
That's pecan.
That's pecan.
That's pecan.
That's pecan.
Thank you.
No, pecan.
What would you say?
I say pecan.
No, why do you say pecan?
Because that's how I was taught.
Interesting, interesting. Thank you. Guys, how do you say this word?
Data.
Data, not data?
No.
Okay,
it's
thank
data,
you.
Man.
Well, it's either pecan or pecan.
So what do you say?
Where are you from? The South?
I don't know.
Well, that determines how you say it.
How do you say it?
It.
I quit. I'm quitting.
You don't like someone beating you in your own game?
No! How do you say this word?
Aunt.
No, nobody says that.
I do. No.
Thank you. I have a question.
No, you don't.
No.
Are you recording that? Yeah, the student is picking on me. And I have to be nice. If I don't do that. That's aunt.
Not aunt?
No, aunt.
Why?
Because that's the right way to say this word.
Okay.
It's not aunt, A-N-T. Like an ant, like,
Can't they be spelled the same way?
Can they?
I quit.
Wait, am I not allowed to ask you questions?
I don't know this.
Well, wait,
he's making fun of the way I see this.
She got
aunt.
Aunt. She literally just got mad because I asked her a question back.
I'm the one that asked the question. I'm the one that asked the question. Do you see what he did to me? Goodbye. I'm so offended. He doesn't ask me questions, I ask the questions. I don't know the answers to said questions. How do you pronounce that word?
Pecan.
Not pecan?
Not pecan.
Why?
Because it's pecan pie if you're from the South.
Interesting. Thank you. Okay, for today. You're the best. I have a question for you guys. How do you say this word?
The correct pronunciation is GIF.
Yeah, well, I'm still going to say it, GIF.
90s. GIF.
Thank you. Do you guys want to all answer a question?
Yes!
Yes!
Anything for you, Miranda.
Okay.
Anything for you, Beyonce.
How do you guys say this word?
It's GIF. It's GIF. If you say GIF, you're...
GIF is with a J.
I will. It's not the peanut butter. That's all I'm saying.
I say GIF. It is graphical.
You're wrong.
Image file, right? So, right. It's not giraffical. I get it.
How? English teacher?
Both pronunciations are technically acceptable, and I think the standard pronunciation should be GIF, if only because the I following the hard G sounds like it does not fit. What an image file is... Fine, forget it.
Thank you!
Wait, no. Language should move from more complex to more simple. Now look, I have to make this glottal sound. I have to g at the back of my throat. G, right? G is here at the front. So I can go from G to the G to the J sound to the I, G. And it's so pleasant. If I start at the back of my throat and I go g, I have to go from back of my throat to the front of my mouth. And it's a journey I don't want to take. I need a GIF.
But it's all about the journey. It's all about the journey.
I pronounce it.
Thank you.
It's about language is about aesthetics too. It's not all just, you know, fucking
promise. Hi guys. How do you say this word?
GIF.
Jiffy, like the peanut butter. Jiff.
Thank you. Have fun with you guys. Hey, I have a question. Oh my God, did I just ask you guys?
You.
Are you stalking me now?
Two vowels go walking, the first one does the talking. Can you see what the word is?
What did you just say?
Two vowels go walking, the first one does the talking. Ant. Come back. No.
Did you just go and try to look that up to
no,
come back?
Yes. I didn't. No, she's my proof. I didn't look it up.
Are there,
I haven't recorded.
Are there any other words in the English dictionary that you can say multiple ways? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay, so I'll take it as that's one of them.
I'm done. I'm kidding. I'm going to tell Bach about this.
That's going to wrap up this week's episode.
Don't forget to check out our website to look into our podcasts and newsletters.
And give a follow to our Instagram page at WashingtonVille.BGTV.
Thanks for watching. I'm Reagan Murphy.
And I'm Megan Miskovic.
Catch you next time, Wizards. To experience opening... Charlotte.
Close the door behind you. I just remembered that the...
God, I'm starving.
This for more information. I'm traveling to Ireland, Scotland. That's my country! Why can't I say it? 6 to 9 p.m. Please stop. Bye. The Little Britain our expo is Friday. Have no fear. Adam Calvin is here. Original music. It's Friday and Saturday.
Oh, Jake, I need the memory card.
Bag.
You put it back or where? It's here?
Oh.
Thanks for watching, Wizards. See you next time. Mwah.